Okay, so welcome to Physics 101 live session, second week. Let's wait a little bit for more people to come, because we are only three. And in the meantime, if you have any questions, you can type or ask. You can use your microphone. I prefer microphone, but you can use also chat, no problem.
Let's wait a little bit for other people to come.
Okay, so we have Mustafa Gülhas Özge, Tesbih. Tesbih, do you understand Turkish? Tesbih, Abdu. Do you understand Turkish, Tesbih? Oh yeah, sometimes I may switch to Turkish, but I mean, the important things, whatever I have to say to students, they're all going to be in English, no problem for that. But sometimes you may hear in Turkish, so don't worry about it. All explanation, all introduction, everything is in English. But sometimes I may switch to Turkish for Turkish students to better communicate with them. Okay, so are there... There are only four students now connected. It's strange because I already posted the messages for this session hour and time, both on UBS and also on Canvas. For people who are connected now, these four people, are anyone of you who has not registered for Canvas yet? Herkes Canvas'a kaydoldu değil mi burada? Let me show the Canvas page for Physics 101. So there is nobody here that who hasn't registered for Canvas yet. That's good, but because you must register for Canvas. Okay, you must register for Canvas first thing first. And there is also this UBS, the official page that your school is providing for the course, the official UBS page. It's shown on the screen now. You're able to see, right? So this is the official page, and let me show to you students who are taking the course. There are, I think, 19 students. 19 students who are taking this course. So anybody who hasn't seen this official web page of the course on UBS, on the school system, herhangi biri bu sayfaya ulaşmama durumu var mı? Herkes bu sayfayı biliyor mu? Herkes biliyor, kabul ediyorum. If you're registered for the course anyway, you must be able to see this page, okay? And you see some announcements also I put over here, that if you haven't registered for the Canvas, is how to do, and this is the link. And if you also want to, there is also a Discord channel, Discord server. If you want to join the Discord server, you can use this link. If you want to, Ahmet Ekrem, are you speaking to me or what?
I guess English.
Okay. So everybody is able to see this page, and there are also you know, the course content, especially the pre-recorded videos, also recording of live sessions on a weekly basis. On this page, you can find, you can click on them just to play any video you want.
Hey, this is Mr. Post. Yeah.
So all resources are there. Okay. I'm speaking English, okay? But sometimes I may switch to Turkish, but you know, this is for only Turkish people, students. And I do all important announcements and all course instruction in English. But sometimes I may speak Turkish, don't worry about it, okay? All right. So, do you understand English? If you understand English, no problem. Because anyway, you must be able to, because the course is in English. Okay. But you know, guys, nobody is using microphone or not giving any feedback. It is as if, you know, I'm speaking to myself. Please try to join, okay? Try to ask questions or join or give some response, yes or no, whatever, okay? Anyway, so as I said, the Canvas is compulsory, and anything you want, any source you need, you can find on the Canvas page. Please go through the first cover page, okay, from top to bottom. Everything is in there. Before you ask me questions or sending me, you know, some questions on the board or emails, please check with the page. Probably your question answers to your question is on the first place on this page. All right. So if there is the other thing is about that the labs, if you have repeating this course, if you have taken this course before, and if your lab grade, average lab grade, is over 60, you are allowed to be exempt from the lab portion of this course. This course, the theory and the lab is united. And for theory, you know, you just follow the course, the videos and take the exams, etc. This is the main part. But if you are repeating this course, and as I say, and if you, you know, if you are just, you know, already taken the lab part, lab report grades is there on a separate grading scheme. That this is how we do when we give this course. Your lab grades and other exams grades are, you know, separated. If your lab grade is over 60, then you may not join the lab reports. You may not, you know, you're not, you're allowed to be exempt from the lab work. In that case, you just send me the proof of your grade, lab grade, if you have taken this course before, with a screenshot of your lab grade from the UBS system. And send it to me. I will just enter. Do this as soon as possible. If you have done this already, then it's no problem. But if you haven't done yet, and if you want to be exempt from the lab, please send me this information, lab grade, as soon as possible. Okay? You know, don't delay it. So, if you are going to take the lab, then you follow my introductions. On what to do for the labs. First of all, you will have only three labs, three experiments. Well, of course, it's going to be a online experiment, not face-to-face or in lab. You will do these three labs. Let me show on UBS. The first lab is about graphing with tracker software. The second lab is about motion in one dimension with constant velocity. And the third one is constant acceleration using tracker. So as you see, if you are taking the labs are going to be performed by using a software which is called tracker. And you can install this software from this link. This is there. on the canvas. You can go there, this link, and download the software and run it on your computer, because you need the tracker. You must download this tracker. So it's open source. It's written by a physicist. And you make sure that your computer has Java installed, because tracker requires Java to run it. And first, you can just install tracker. You just check it whether it's running or not. If it's not running, and then check with Java. Java must be installed on your computer, but most computers has already Java installed. Okay. Do we have a lab lesson for the first of all? Of course, we have lab lessons. I will introduce you what to do for labs, for each lab, okay? And it's already pre-recorded. All these videos are pre-recorded. Okay, let's go over the lab first. For those of you who are going to take the lab. First of all, the thing is that you have only 1 week to complete your lab report, starting from today, because I'm introducing the first lab today. Starting from today, you have only 1 week to write this report. If you have groups, I already made announcements about the groups. If you have groups, each group will submit only one report, okay? But if you want to do it all by yourself, then you can do it. You can write up your report all by yourself. That's also fine. So you have 1 week, and let me show, let's start with the first lab. If you click over it, you will just, you know, be taken to the report page. And on the report page, everything is written and what to the instructions, etc. There is also a video recording which is put on YouTube. You can watch it on how, you know, to do this first graphing with the tracker software. Okay, it's over here, and it's step by step, and it's also written by text in English on what to do on the first lab. So read it, okay? I'm not going to read it, because this is your job, and you must read your homework, okay? You must read first your homework on what to do. And then in addition to this video, there is also a second video over here. You will see the item number 5. This video is also an instruction to the first lab. And probably you hear.
The first column is the,
you know, step by step, again, I explain what to do for the first lab, how to enter these data tables. There are 3 different data tables, and these data tables are to be plotted by using tracker. And on that video, on this video, I explain everything step by step. There are also, some of the operations to do after you enter. You just put all these data one by one, because there are 3 sets of data. You will perform all tasks for each and every table. For each table, you do some of the things. First try to fit a baseline to your data. And again, this is all explained in the videos. And there are some also calculations to do, okay? There are some calculations to do. You have to make these calculations and put over your lab report. And how are you going to prepare your lab? There is this lab template over here, okay? Lab template over here, and these are the same. Anyway, this, if you click on this lab template, the canvas will take you to the template, and you can download this template. You can download this template by clicking over here. You can open up. You can open this up in your Microsoft Word or Office. You must have Office, and you will use this template. You must use this template, okay, to submit your report. You're going to submit your report on the basis of this template, okay? So you must fill this template and you just submit it by using, there is going to be a submit button over somewhere here, because this is, let me switch to student view. Okay, you see there is this button, start assignment. When you click start assignment, you have to upload your report by using the buttons which is provided on the page anyway. You will find it, okay? All right. So, any questions so far? I think there is a problem with your internet connection. Do you have any problems with the connection for other students? I'm just asking because one of you, Gülhas, is saying that there is an internet problem. İnternet problemi var mı? Yaşayan var mı? İnternet problemi sizin bağlantı hızınızdan kaynaklanabilir. Ben okuldayım şu anda. Okulun bağlantı hızı her şeyin üstünde çok yüksek. Arkadaşlar bir cevap verin ya. Do you have any problems with the connection? Anybody? If anybody has problems, please type here. Okay, I will ask one by one. Kyra, do you have a problem with my voice? Do you hear my voice? Do you see the pictures, the videos and everything? Is that okay? Ahmet Akram, Furkan, Gülhas, Mustafa Özge, Tesbih. Do you have any problems with the connection? Okay. So for people who has problems with the connection, it's because of your connection with the internet. Okay. It's not the problem of my connection because I'm connecting through my school system and the school has over 100 gigabits of speed. So anyway, this video is recorded, okay? This live session is recorded. You may watch this live session. I will put this recording onto the page, on Canvas, on the YouTube channel of the course, and also on UBS. You can rewatch again, okay? No problem. So if you have right now a connection problem, I am recording this. I will put this recording into resources so you can watch it later. No problem. Okay, so I was talking about how to do the first lab. And as I said, since the lab introduction is already on this video, okay, if you click on this video, between 6 minutes and 45 seconds and between 6 minutes and 42 minutes on this part, you will find a detailed instruction for the first lab, okay? I already recorded this. You refer to this video on how to do it. But if you further, you may have, questions or problems with writing up the report, then in that case, you may put your questions. You may put your questions as an answer to this, as a post to this announcement. Okay, just reply to this. Whatever the problem you have, just post your question over here on this announcement. You see, please post your questions and reply to this announcement. All of your questions. Don't send me a private email. Messages to ask questions, because your questions are asked by many students, the same questions, and I cannot reply the same question over and over again. If you put your question on Canvas so that everybody can see it, I will answer once, and this answer is once for all students. Okay, please notice this important step, which will be done by you. You know, ask your questions in that way. Just post your questions on the Canvas announcement as a reply to this post, to this special announcement. Just put your questions over here. Okay? I'm not going to answer your questions through email one by one. Don't send me email. Put your questions on the Canvas so that everybody can see your questions. I hope this is clear, okay? Because I have been asked many questions, the same questions over many students last week, and I'm answering each of them one by one, so it's you know, time consuming for me. Okay. All right, so again, when it, we go back to the report. So do you have any questions so far for the report? When everything is clear, what to do, please act immediately. Don't try to delay writing up your report to the last day, okay? This is my recommendation to you. And don't just delay your questions to the last day of the report submitting day. And act or do your homework from this day on, okay? You have 1 week. Writing report in one day is not possible. You have to work on it, okay? At least you need 2 or 3 days. Work on it, and you will have some problems. You will face some difficulties. You must have some time to ask these questions and get the answer from me. If you do everything on the last night, you will not be able to submit your report. And one thing that is, please do not copy others' report, other students' report. Do not copy, okay? Plagiarism is strictly forbidden in this course. Türkçe'de söylüyorum. Let me say in Turkish, sakın başka birinin raporunu buraya yazmayın, yüklemeyin. Eğer böyle bir şey yaparsanız, sadece sıfır almakla bırakmam, aynı zamanda disipline gönderirim. Şunu da söyleyeyim, bir program var bizim Canvas'ta, otomatik olarak check ediyor. Çünkü her şey dijital ortamda, otomatik olarak check ediyor ve birbirinin aynısı raporları buluyor. Birbirinin aynısı veya bir kısmı da aynı da olsa onları da buluyor. Hatta size şunu da söyleyeyim. Geçmiş senelerin raporlarını bize kendi raporumuş gibi yükleyen öğrenciler de vardı. Onları da yakaladık. O yüzden dikkatli olun. Bütün raporları kendiniz yapın. Eğer grup olarak yapıyorsanız zaten grup olarak bir rapor teslim edeceksiniz. Kendiniz yapıyorsanız tamamen kendiniz yazacaksınız. Sakın kopya çekmeyin. Bu bir uyarıdır. Baştan söyleyeyim size. Disiplinle sonuçlanabilir eğer bunu dinlemezseniz. So I strictly warn you that the plagiarism is not going to be tolerated for this course, especially for your reports, also for your exams, of course. Okay, so do you have any questions so far on the reports, the labs, and everything? Any questions? Okay, no question is an answer also. So thank you for giving me some response that proving that you're not dead. Okay, so I think everything is clear about you know, what to do for reports, and I will today just assign the deadline. By the way, you must be careful on you know, let me show also this rubric. Is it viewable by students? Let me see. Yeah. At the very end of the page of report submission, you will see a table called the full report rubric. This is rubric, and I don't know whether you know what a rubric is. This is the guideline for instructors, and the guideline for us to grade your report. And we go with the guidelines that first we have some criteria, for example, cover sheet and abstract. On the cover sheet and abstract, you must have a cover sheet, but the cover sheet is already in your template, okay? So if you don't have a cover sheet and if you don't have an abstract, then that means you will lose 20% of your grade. If you do everything in whatever it said in over here, just read these criteria, go over this criteria when you're writing the parts of your report. It's clearly written what to do for this part. For coherence abstract, you must read this, and it's there how to write up or what to do on this part. And also data sheets and sample calculations and graph design, if you have graphs to plot in your report, discussions and results. Just read over these criteria, because I will grade, or the assistants will grade your reports by using this rubric, by using this criteria. If, for example, for the cover and cover sheet and abstract, if you are okay but you have some missing parts, you will get 20 points. If everything is full, you get 20 points. If there are some missing parts, it's 12 points. If there are many missing parts, you get 5 points. If there is nothing or everything is wrong, then you get 0 points. So for each part, you see these grading scale and ratings, whatever you call. Okay. So this is also you should take into consideration when you're writing up your report. And is that clear? Okay. So first thing first, just if you don't have this tracker software, go to this link and download this tracker. It's a free open source software. You must install it, and you will use this software for all of your lab reports, for all of your labs. If you may have some problems, because you may have some problems running on for this software, if you do it immediately, then you just let me know if you have problems running the software beforehand. If you do this again to the last days, I can help you, because you have and don't ask me to just delay the submission due date. I'm not going to delay the submission due date. 1 week for sharp. End of one week, if you're not submitting report, then you get zero, nil. So 1 week is more than enough, okay? Well, anyway, it's, this course is condensed, Everything you get, try to learn in 5 weeks only. This is especially designed for people who are repeating the course. But if you're taking this course for the first time, keep in mind that this is not a good pacing, good time for taking this course for the first time in the summer term. Well, if you're taking that, so that's it. I mean, taking it. It's your responsibility to learn in 5 weeks. If you're taking this course for the first time, I don't think that's it's a wise thing to take physics course in the summer term in 5 weeks only, okay? But if you already taken it, then that means you're very strict, you're hardworking, that's okay for me. But responsibilities belong to you. So in 10 minutes, the live session will be closing because of time limitation and Zoom. But if you are just kicked out from the meeting, then just by using the same link that I sent to you, try to connect, okay? We will continue wherever we kicked out by Zoom. We will continue from there by using the same link. Okay. So any questions so far? Any questions? Okay, so let's come to the first page of Canvas page again. So you see over here the weekly schedule of the course. Let me enlarge it. This is the weekly schedule. This is the second week, you know, and we have already covered these subjects on last week. Significant figures, units, conversion, uncertainty, 1D motion, free fall, vectors, 2D motion, etc. All the videos for this first week are on also the YouTube channel that belongs to this course. So the YouTube channel you can reach by clicking this link, okay? By clicking this link, you can reach the YouTube channel for the course, and this channel has more than 110 videos, 140 videos, and there are also more. And this is the complete videos of the course. You can find the video instruction to all of your units, subjects, parts, whatever you may call, together with problem solutions and recitation hours, together with detailed problem solutions. You have the complete video list for this course, okay? I think no any other course in this school will provide this that much resources to you. And these resources are all always updated, and I started forming these videos 10 years ago. I started 10 years ago, and there are all always new videos are coming, joining to this list. So it's always updated. And you can find all of the subjects in your weekly schedule in this YouTube channel playlist, okay? This is a complete resource, and this is for your benefit, okay? So you can watch, and the other thing is that these videos are full HD, okay? They are crystal clear, and you will be able to see all my writings very, very neat and well, without any blurring, without any bad resolution. If I have done all the live instructions by using the school system, UBS system, it will be terrible, okay? Because school system video resolution sucks. It's less than half of the HD videos. It sucks. So that's why I'm using YouTube channel, and there is lots of work. There is tremendous amount of work which is paid to form this video list. So respect it and go over these videos, okay? And even so, even you watch these videos, okay, you are completely free to ask me specific questions about, it may be about videos, by putting comments on below these videos in YouTube channel. You can do it. You can put your comments on the related video so that I can easily understand your question about the part of the video that, you know, that you didn't understand or you have problems. If you put your questions also relating the videos onto YouTube channel, we on the bottom comments session part, that will be very much appreciated by me, because in that way I will be answering your questions through the YouTube channel, and everybody will be seeing it. Everybody will get the benefit from your questions. Okay. And I claim that this instructions, this resources is way better than face-to-face education. I claim this. Apart from the labs, of course, for the labs, there is nothing that we can replace the lab experience. that's a different story. But in terms of these video instructions in class, theoretical instructions of the course, these resources is way much better than face-to-face education. Because when I go over the classroom, barely one or maybe two people, not all the time, is asking question, even in the classroom, physical classroom, in face-to-face education. Not many students are asking questions, okay? It may be, maybe they are hesitating, they are maybe shy, I don't know. Very few people, not all the time, are interacting with me in the classroom. But this way, you know, you don't have to be shy. Just to type your question. It may be silly or whatever, okay? I will answer them. And, you know, there are hundreds of videos. And they're all recorded by me. They're all prepared by me. So it's all there. And it's always updated. Okay. So, please, you know, take these recommendations by me into account. This way, you know, you will be able to go over some of my explanations over and over. Well, this is not possible for, you know, face-to-face, real-time, all the classical way. So you cannot watch my introduction or my classes anytime after the class ends. So it's not recorded, right? But for this, you may watch them anywhere, anytime you want. You can respond them, you can comment on them. You can make comments, you can make ask questions on them. So, Don Estius. Tabii bu just pardon my Turkish, but not just I'm repeating whatever I said. Bu uzaktan eğitim belki size şey gelebilir. Dezavantajlı bir durum gibi gelebilir. Mesele burada kendinizi self disipline etmek. Eğer kendinize düzenli zaman ayırıp düzenli bir şekilde bu kaynakları gerektiği gibi kullanırsanız bu durum sizin avantajınızdadır. Yani dediğim gibi tabii ki laboratuvar deneyimi ayrı bir şey. Onun yerini uzaktan halledemeyiz. Ama öyle bile olsa bu yine göreceksiniz. Onun bile eksikliğini neredeyse hissettirmeyecek. Size gerçek deney videoları üzerinden deney yaptırıyoruz. Bundan sonraki iki deneyinizde göreceksiniz. Yani sabit hız ve sabit ivme kavramlarını, onda ölçmeyi nasıl alacağız? Onların hatasını nasıl bulacağız? Bunda bile gerçek laboratuvarda yapamadığınız şeyleri yapacaksınız. Tabii ki gerçek laboratuvarda cihaz kullanımı falan vesaire konusunda ayrı bir deneyim ama temel laboratuvar teknikleri, hata analizi vesaire gibi durumlarda bazı yönlerden avantajlı bile olabilir. Birazdan video, so the Zoom will kick out as soon. Just, you know, use the same link to connect again. I will continue, okay? Or I'm ending this session right here because our time is up, 40 minutes. So I will